Welcome everyone. I hope you have already watched part 1 of episode 10. If not, you may find the link in the description below. In today's session, we take a look at the process of recovering dues once a demand notice under section 8 of the code has been issued, a period of 10 days since issuance of the notice has passed by, no repayment is yet received, and no notice of any dispute is received by the operational creditor. The second stage of the recovery process requires a duly licensed advocate. In this stage, and as per Section 9 of the Insolvency and Bankruptcy Code 2016, an application is to be filed before the adjudicating authority, that is the National Company Law Tribunal, for initiating a corporate insolvency resolution process. This application is in the format which has been provided by the government in the Insolvency Rules 2016. In the application, a lot of factual details are required to be provided, such as details of the entities involved, invoices that have been issued, contracts and correspondences, and other relevant details. Along with this application, the applicant must pay the prescribed fees, which I believe at present in Mumbai stands to a tune of 2,500 rupees. This payment is made directly to the government towards filing of the application. Along with the application, the applicant must furnish certain details and documents such as a copy of the invoices, an affidavit confirming issuance of the notice, and a confirmation from a financial institution, that's a bank, with regards to having not received the amounts. At this stage, the applicant may recommend the name of a resolution professional if the applicant knows one, else that field can be left blank. There are few technical aspects to this application, such as the manner of printing such application, number of copies, service of summons, providing a CD with all scanned documents, etc., which needs to be handled with care to avoid unnecessary delays. Under Section 9, Subsection 5, the adjudicating authority has 14 days from the date of submission of the application to either admit or reject the application. In case of rejection, the adjudicating authority must provide an opportunity of 7 days to the applicant so as to enable the applicant to rectify the defects in the claim. These defects are also to be informed to the applicant by the authority. Once admitted, the corporate insolvency resolution process commences. As per Section 12 of the Code, the entire corporate insolvency resolution process must be concluded within a period of 330 days of admission of the proceedings. This period includes a period of extension, if granted, for 90 days, which the adjudicating authority, on the request of the resolution professional, may grant, provided the formalities under Section 12, Subsection 2 have been complied with. The adjudicating authority also has the right to extend this period if required in the adjudicating authority's opinion. That will be all for this stage. Stay tuned for the final stage on how to recover dues using IBC. If you enjoyed this video, please don't forget to subscribe, like, and share.